hope, transformation, innovation, way forward, nature-based solutions. These are some of the elements that we are giving awards today.
A changing climate impacts all of us, but not equally. And we know that women and girls are disproportionately impacted by climate change, particularly in developing countries. Now, we all support an effective response to climate change, but the response can only be fully effective if the experiences and capacities of women are valued and embraced.
Women need to be much more, not only on the stage, but also be part of the climate negotiations, be it here in Marrakesh, or be it on a national or on a local level. Without women, this is not going to fly. It's as simple as that. It's not about ideology. It's even not about rights, although I think it is. But for the non-believers, you just will not get there if you don't involve women.
What we need to do is educate more women. I think education, learning, and providing opportunities are platforms for women to be able to basically take part and participate is extremely important. Once women are educated, the possibilities of them engaging in the debate on a higher level in any sector, like in a policy shaping or in technology designing or shaping the negotiation here in COP is extremely important.
$100 million invested across energy, agriculture, education, healthcare. My conclusion is, if you are talking about poverty, you have to look at energy. And if you are looking at energy, you have to understand women's role in it, because energy has everything to do with poverty and energy has everything to do with women.
We are investing total of around $1 billion at the moment.
And how many women are you employing and developing?
Come back to work, and I decided to take over the position of the president of the National Women of Thailand. Now I convinced the 30 million women in Thailand to do better, to make a better world, to hand over to our next generation.
Gender equality and women's empowerment achievement is about transformation and radical transformation and breaking bad old habits and structures. And this is something that requires, of course, the self-awareness, confidence, and determination of women and girls themselves. As I keep saying, the consciousness revolution amongst women and girls. But equally, it requires the other half to really join the mainstream of the gender equality transformation.
For us, this, convincing men with the importance of integrating women into the decision-making process and to being part of the whole, decision-making process, part of being part of the workforce, part of the developing a strategy, part of implementing a strategy, hasn't been a big challenge. I think our bigger challenge was basically getting more women into, in our case, for example, in STEM education and STEM, they are in the education, but to get them into the workforce. I'm very proud that in the UAE, because the leadership has been extremely supportive of women engagement empowerment, and I think, everything we do is to see it, to get the women to look into these opportunities and seek these opportunities and this platform to excel.